In this video, you will know what is JSX, the benefits of using JSX, how JSX works, adjustments you need to make when using JSX, how to use expressions in JSX, and some things you need to take note of while using JSX. We are going to be using a lot of JSX in React, so we need to know these things before we can further our knowledge on React. So let's get started. Hello guys, welcome to HDev. My name is Agane Friday. So let's start by knowing what JSX is. JSX fully stands for JavaScript XML. JSX is a JavaScript language syntax extension. It looks like standard HTML and often confused for a template engine. But JSX is not the same as standard HTML and also not a template engine. You can see an example of JSX here. JSX has tag names, attributes, and children just like XML and also HTML. You can see an attribute here. Using JSX is not a must. That is, it's not compulsory. It's optional. There are alternatives. JSX is a bit confusing for beginners that are used to standard HTML and vanilla JavaScript. But after getting to know JSX, they discover that it's very easy to write and also easy to use. Elements can be created with React Create Element, but using JSX makes element creation faster and also simpler. As you can see here now, this is Babel. As you can see, this code right here does the same thing with this one, but you can see this one is neat, short, and easy to comprehend. This one, it's a bit complex. So here, if you're building something big, it can get messy here easily. But with this is JSX here. With JSX, your code will be neat, clean, easy to read, and also to use. JSX is transpiled by Babel to JavaScript so that it can be usable in the browser. Transpiling is a process whereby a source code of a program written in a programming language is being converted or transformed into another programming language that does the same thing as the programming language it's being converted from. So transpilation is conversion of a source code from one programming language, that is JSX now, to JavaScript, because JavaScript is the language that the browser can understand. So Babel transpiles the code from JSX to JavaScript, which the browser will be able to understand. That is how JSX works. It's being transpiled by Babel to JavaScript so that the browser can use the JavaScript, because the browser does not understand JSX. If you are enjoying the video to this extent, like the video and subscribing to the channel will be amazing for us. Thank you. When you are using JSX, there are some adjustments that you will need to make, especially if you are already used to standard HTML. These adjustments are: in standard HTML, we have class as an attribute, but in JSX, instead of the normal class in standard HTML, we have class name. As you can see here, it's the same thing as class in standard HTML, but class is a reserved keyword in React, so we can use it in JSX. Instead, we use class name in JSX. And also in standard HTML, when you are using label, we use for, but in JSX we use HTML for. When you are using for in JSX, but in standard HTML we use for. As you can see here, I have HTML for hello. I just created the element just to show you guys. Those are the main changes in the attributes. ID remains the same. These are the main changes in JSX. Properties. When you are using properties, as in camel case, naming convention is used in writing the names of properties in JSX. Like in the case of onClick. Yeah, onClick. When you are using standard HTML, you can write small letter C for the click. But in JSX, we use capital letter for another word when you're using two words. So that is a naming convention. We have other things like onChange. The C for change is written in capital letter instead of small letter that is used in standard HTML. And we have tab index. The I for index is written in capital letter. These are the main adjustments that are in JSX. So if you start using JSX, you get used to those changes. Expressions are written in curly braces in JSX. That is, when you want to use expressions in JSX, you write them inside the curly braces. Like I have name here. If I want to use the name in my JSX, I will bring the curly braces, then write the expression and save. Let me open the browser so that you can see it. As you can see, hello world hdev. Let me show you the code. You can see hello world hdev. Hello world, the expression, like let me say welcome to hdev instead. Then let me save it. Let's head to the browser and see. You can see welcome to hdev. Then expressions can be React variables, property, or any other valid JavaScript expression. JSX executes the expression and return the result. Like one, if we are to inspect the browser now, you won't see the expression directly. You will just see the result, like, and that is hdev in the browser instead of the expression itself. So the result is what JSX sends to the browser, not the expression. So you can do a lot of things in the curly braces, but you won't see them. You just see the results in your browser instead. When you are using React, these are things you need to take note of. If statements are not supported in JSX, or it can be used in React but not in JSX. So when you want to use if statement in JSX, you use ternary expressions instead. JSX must be wrapped in one top level element. That is, when you have multiple elements, you need to wrap them. You need to have a parent element, then that will wrap your elements, as in the multiple elements that you have. You need to wrap them with either a div, a fragment, as in an element without tag name, or a React fragment. Elements must be closed. Using JSX, you must close the elements. Those are the main things that you need to know. If you enjoyed the video, please like the video and share the video to your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and also click on the notification bell to receive updates anytime we drop a new video. Thank you.